British Boxers time, and we're at Team Fury headquarters. We're going to do a little catch up with Savannah Marshall and Peter McDonough. Savannah's already down here. She's taken, you know, not very long to get ready. Peter's still getting ready. So I'll tell you what, why don't we go up and just get him, catch him on the ways? Shall we do it?
Yeah.
Come on, let's do it, right. So we're going to go and see where the magic happens. So we'll follow Savannah. So this is where you stay then, Savannah?
At the minute,
just above the gym.
Yeah.
Very nice. So, alright, take us in here for a start while we're waiting for Peter. So is this where you guys chill out?
This is the front room.
Yeah, very nice, very nice. So whose chair is that one?
That's where you live when you're knackered.
Yeah.
When you've hit the wall.
Well, you know, you've done a hard session today. Have you hit the wall today?
Nearly.
Yeah.
So I sit in that chair.
That one. You sit on this chair and just face the wall, do you? you know, what's your daily routine like? What time do you get up?
Our first session's at 10. Yeah. So sometimes I get up 10:10. Now I get up at like 9, 8, and then we train at 10, so.
Train at 10, so now you've got a little bit of downtime. What do you normally do? I know now you've got us putting cameras in your face, but what would you normally do in your downtime?
I'd eat now and then just chill out. Maybe have a little sleep, watch some telly. Till 5.
That's alright, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, what do you do your own cooking?
Yeah, we either eat it or there's like a bakery over the road and she does like chicken and rice and stuff like that.
Yeah. Alright, why don't you just give us a little bit more of a tour then? It's like MTV Cribs, this.
Have you been in there before?
I have, but it was a long time ago. We've got, just get a little shot of Peter McDonough chilling there as well. we'll catch Peter in a second because he's on the phone, but just give us a little tour. Can we, you know, see where the magic happens?
So this is my room. Just clothes, sweaty clothes. Clean clothes.
To be honest though, I thought it was going to be a lot less like luxurious and that sort of stuff, but it's actually pretty nice, you know, for a box of digs. I mean,
yeah,
I think you've saved a lot worse travelling around, haven't you?
The carpets are quite thick.
Yeah.
So that's nice.
Have you ever, you know, with your amateur experience, you've been all over the world, haven't you? Did you ever stay in any real sort of dives?
Yeah, God, the worst place I've ever been is Kazakhstan.
Yeah.
I went for 2 weeks and it was horrific. Honestly, I was close to wrapping in.
Seriously? What were
we
talking?
No telly, we're in the middle of nowhere, steel like fence around where we were staying. It was awful, honestly. It was just like gruel every day.
Really?
I hit the wall there.
How did you get on out there though?
It was just a training camp, this one.
Right.
It's the best one I've ever been to.
Well, it's made Golovkin the man he is today, hasn't it?
Yeah, it has, yeah.
Where's the best place you've ever been? What's had the most like high-tech facilities around the world?
The best place I've ever been, facilities, is Japan.
Yeah.
That was brilliant, even down to the food. You knew what was in everything.
Yeah.
But my favourite place, I went to the World Championships in Barbados. 2010, nice. And the pre-camp was in Miami.
Wow.
So that was like ticking two boxes off there.
Wow, so for a girl from up north who may not have had those opportunities to go to certain countries, you've actually, boxing has given you more than just
a
career, hasn't it? And you know, when you're off on your travels around, you know, are you sort of used to being on your own? Are you used to just being in different places?
Yeah, it's got the point now where I can't stay at home for too long. Because it irritates me. So coming here and then going home, you know, every now and again, makes me appreciate Hartlepool.
Yeah.
The people in it.
And you mentioned there one of the worst things about Kazakhstan was no TV. What sort of stuff do you like watching?
Nothing, but just something to pass the time. But there was nothing. There was no Wi-Fi, so you couldn't even go on your phone. There was a little tuck shop. And at the end of the week, one of the coaches promised us one item from the tuck shop. And it was a toss-up between a bag of crisps and a can of Coke, and I went for the crisps.
Yeah.
I should have went for the Coke. Because they were about 8 months out of date.
Yep. There we are. Yep. Yep.
What do you find the hardest bit about sort of training camps? Is diet something that you find difficult, or is it something, because you seem very dedicated?
No, I've never ever struggled with my diet, but only when I was younger I used to drop weight like that so easy. I used to always be under the weight limit, but only now I'm just starting, like I'm 26, I'm starting to, like, not struggle, but I'm starting to feel it a bit. Like, it's got the point where I have to wear, do you know, like an extra layer, like that type of thing, so yeah.
What's, just talk back to, you know, living here, how long are you actually living here for?
So we've got 5 weeks till May the 12th,
yeah,
or just under five, and we've already done five, so it's a 10-week camp.
Well, it's a good job you get on with the rest, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise it could be a nightmare. Have you ever been away somewhere where you've just really not got on with the people that you're with?
No, I'm quite quiet and keep myself to myself anyway, but do you know, you don't get much better people than the people I'm with at the minute.
Yeah, you got a good crew, haven't you? Yeah, you are quite chilled, aren't you? I mean, how did you get into boxing in the first place? Like, what made you decide? Because it's, you know, not in any way to be, you know, in any terms of gender, but obviously for a young girl growing up, there's different options are often pushed their way. So how did you end up in the boxing?
No, the reason why I first started was I was 11, and one of my friends out the street used to box, and I'd always remember him going and. Yeah, he'd done really quite well. I think he won national titles and everything, and I was only 11. I remember him running up the street with his trophy. I got a bit jealous and I thought, I'll win a trophy, I'll show you. And like, what's that, 15 years on?
Wow.
Still doing it, that trophy.
Does he still box?
No, he doesn't box no more, but he's still into it, so.
Are you still friends with everyone you grew up with, like back home?
Yeah. I'm still really good friends with them. So when I was on GB, I was on there for 8 years, which is a hell of a long time. And I'm really good friends with Chantal Cameron.
She's brilliant.
Really, really good friends, and she's doing really well.
Mm.
Really well. She's like my good friend, so I know I look up to.
Well, yeah, last time I spoke to you, you mentioned that Lomachenko is one of your favourites on the scene.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, obviously in the female game, there's now becoming some real emerging stars, isn't there? So other than Chantal Cameron, is there anyone else, you know, in the female game that you look up to?
Katie Taylor, the legend that she is. Everyone really. Do you know, it's hard, it's really hard for women. Like, although, you know, the women are just starting to get, you know, the respect that men get, but even like stuff like down to pay and publicity, and, you know, we're still years behind.
Do you just spar with the lads here? Or do you, just spar with the lads? Do you not bring anyone, anyone in special, then you literally spar with the lads in the camp?
I suppose it'd be a lot different once I start boxing for titles, and you know who you actually know who you're boxing in weeks and weeks in advance. But at the minute, I'm just sparring the lads. But for me, sparring the lads, then when I come to spar women, you don't get women that can hit like men or move like men. So it's a bit of an advantage, I find.
And do you ever find that like the lads lay off you a bit, or do they really go for it and give you that experience that you need in terms of?
I think sometimes they pull the power, which is, you know, but then there is times when I've had men try to knock me out, and I just think, dickhead. Because it's not natural, isn't it? Women are naturally weaker anyway. So when men do pull the power, I just. It's a respect thing, isn't it?
Yeah. One thing I noticed about you, and I've always noticed about you from watching you either compete or train, your movement is fantastic. You know, and that's one of the features that characterises this particular gym, in that, you know, you guys have all got great footwork drills and that.
Yeah.
Is that something you've always had, and has it come along a lot since you've been working with Peter?
I think I have changed a hell of a lot since I started working with Peter. I was working with him from my debut, and I really liked what I'd become and what I've learned, so this is the reason why I've come back, because I do like what he teaches. Don't get me wrong, it's really hard work, some of the stuff he has is doing. I think, you know, he's trying to break me, but it's good. Yeah,
I get the sense with Peter though that he does actually
try to break you
to find out what your metal's about. So you've obviously passed the test.
I think I've just got I've got a good poker face.
Yeah,
so I think he's broke me a couple of times, but he hasn't caught on yet.
Yeah, brilliant. Well, you know what? That's a good, a real good insight into a bit more about Savannah Marshall. Because people always say to me, "Oh, she's great and that," but we haven't really got that much in depth on her and that. But for what it boils down to, you just seem to be very, very dedicated to the sport.
I think it's got the point now where, like I said, I've been boxing since I was 11, so I've put all my life into it. So these last couple of years, I just, you know, this is me getting out what I've put in, really. Hopefully.
And what's the sort of, I mean, obviously world title, so with someone of your standard of the in the amateur career, I mean, I'm sure the ambition is a world title, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. Definitely, like, I think my weight class, so around my weight class, like super well, middleweight, super middle, out of the women, it's got the most contenders in. Like, no disrespect to other weight class, but there's Christina Hammer, the German, obviously Clarissa Shields.
Yeah.
And there's a good handful of women in that mix where I think, you know, like lightweight, maybe it's because it's not my weight, but like Bantam, I only really know Nikki.
Yeah.
Lightweight, Chantel and Katie. But I feel like at mine's a lot more busier, more exciting. But that's just my opinion.
Well, do you think we're going to see that rematch with Clarissa Shields some point in the future?
Yeah, definitely. I think she's the one, really, isn't she?
Yeah.
So if I want to make it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But she's not been on Mayweather McGregor undercard, has she?
No, she hasn't.
There you go. And I suppose, though, in your own mind, you probably want to push yourself, don't you, and get back in the ring with her.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Of course. Yeah. I feel like I last boxed there 4 or 5 years ago now.
Yeah.
It was a long time ago. It was the old point scoring system. Yeah. So, but I've changed a lot since then, and I know she has as well. So it's exciting. I'm excited. You know, I'd love to box her again.
Yeah.
I'm sure where she wants to box me.
Oh, she does. I've heard her say it. And just one final thing, really. I mean, I remember when I spoke to Peter Fury about you know, his take on female boxing, and what he said is he likes to train fighters who are going to go for the knockout. You know, it's no different, he said, it's no different. So I think he likes making your style where you actually go for the knockout, don't you?
Yeah, that's quite nice that he said that.
So if you watch my interviews, you'd know that.
I told you I don't like the sound of your voice. So
yeah, well, you know what, it's been good catching up and getting a bit more of an insight into stuff. And 12th of May, you're out in Bolton White's Hotel.
The Macron Stadium.
Oh, the Macron Stadium, is it? Yeah, of course, for Yui Fury, Sam Sexton's undercard.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, brilliant. Well, Savannah, thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.